Okay. Now let's see this question. This question came in GATE 2012 for 2 marks. The question is, suppose a circular queue of capacity n minus 1 elements is implemented with an array of n elements. Okay. So a circular queue is there whose capacity is n minus 1 elements, but it is implemented with an array whose size is n elements. Assume that the insertion and deletion operations are carried out using rear and front, okay, these pointers as array index variables. Okay, now initially what is happening is that rear is equal to front is equal to 0. Okay, so they are saying that let's say okay, there is an array and let's say n is equal to, let's say, 3 to 5, right? So 5 is only value of n. So these are n elements. So its capacity will be n minus 1, which is 4. Only 4 elements we can insert in this. Now, they are also saying that rear and front. So the front and rear. So initially, front and rear, both are pointing to the index 0. So this is index 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the condition to detect Q full and Q empty are what? This we have to find out. Firstly, let's understand that how the Q is going to grow. Okay. So, what happens when we are inserting one element? What happens when we are inserting another element or deleting or removing another element? So we can read this line again. Assume that the insertion and deletion operations are carried out using rear and front as array index variables respectively, which means that when we are inserting using from backside. Okay. And when we are deleting, then we are deleting from front. So usual queue operations. Okay, so what's going to happen? See, one element comes here, then front is still here, isn't it? But the rear moves here. Okay, so this is the pattern which we are going to follow. So what is going to happen as new elements are coming, we are going to shift the rear pointer forward. Okay, so we can say that only 4 elements can be here. So when it comes here, then it is going to be here, and when it comes, one more element is inserted, then it is going to be here. Okay, so the final situation is something like this. After insertion of the 4 element, the queue is now full and front is here and rear is here. Now it does not matter whether the situation is currently this, but another situation can be something like this also. See, in the same queue, let's say you DQ 2 elements. So currently R is here, and let's say you DQ 2 elements. So now when you DQ this, front comes here. When you again DQ this, the front comes here. Okay, so basically this is the situation. Now the capacity is 4, but now 2 elements are only there, so you can insert 2 more elements, right? So once you insert one here, then rear is going to come here, okay, and another one when you insert, then rear is going to come here, and now again the capacity is full. So what my point is, that why I gave you these examples, that irrespective of whether you are inserting or deleting in what order, it does not matter, but what happens is that when you start from this condition, rear is equal to front is equal to 0, then what is going to happen? Whenever the queue becomes full, then in all cases we are seeing a thing that the rear one is one step behind front. How one step behind? See, here you can clearly see that rear is one slot behind F. Here also that is the case, because you can think of it obviously as a, you will think it as circular one, right? So what will be the next slot after this? Actually this one, and here there is actually F is there. So basically what my point is that whatever place R is there, whatever index R is there, you add one and take mod n. Why? Because that is the number of elements in the array. So 5 elements are there, so you take mod n, and that is basically the index which will give you F. So that's why I took another example here, because here also you can clearly see what is happening. When you take R plus 1, then no need to take even mod, but mod will give you the same value, and that is going to give the index where front pointer is there. So this is the condition for full, and that was the most tricky one, because empty is pretty straightforward, because that is the condition which is given. Initially rear is equal to front is equal to 0, and that's why rear is equal to front. That is the condition for empty, and for full we have discussed R plus 1 mod n. So now we can clearly see that empty, rear is equal to front, and for full, rear plus 1 mod n is equal to front. So A is the correct answer.